Hi, I'm Katrin. This is my channel. You are very welcome. Today I hope we will see another side of Morgan. This poor man have lost it totally. In my last video he finally recognized Rick. It ended with Rick asking him to come with them. This is Morgan Jones from my point of view. Morgan has decided to stay. He is not finished here yet. He can see Rick's son and friend arrive from the round through the town stores. Morgan was busy. He have some new walkers to take care of. He tied them to his straps. When Rick's son Carl walked by Morgan, he said, "Hey, Morgan, I had to shoot you. You know I had to. I'm sorry." Morgan understood that, of course, and he said, "Hey, son, don't ever be sorry." Then he went back to work on his traps, and Rick, Carl and Michonne packed the car and drove away. Time passes by. I think it's at least a year, maybe more, until we meet up with Morgan again. What I understand about Morgan's life that we come into now is that he lives a more quiet and simple life. I believe that he have followed the sign for the sanctuary that a lot of other people have done too. When he finally got closer, he found this sign, "No Sanctuary." Okay, what will he do now? There are no one around here. He take a pause and gather his thoughts. Then he saw a cross, like a sign, as it was made for him. He passed the tree with a cross and walked deeper into the forest and began to follow the trail. More time goes by, I should think at least a couple of months. There, another cross. It does not tell how many trees with crosses he have found during this time, if this is the next one, or if the trail have been long. This looks like a school. Is it abandoned or does someone live there? I sense that Morgan still are in the same mood like the last time we saw him. I can feel his calm through the screen. Well, it looked abandoned. He saw a walker. He sat down beside it, looked at it, and it seems like he saw the person it once was. Gently, he put it out of his misery. He went back into the forest, and nearby he can see a church. It looked abandoned too. There have been some struggle here, he can tell that. He went inside, and here he found some well-needed things. He lighted a candle and looked over the stuff that was left here. Something in this church released something in Morgan. We can see a big smile on his face. A bigger smile have never been seen. It warms your heart. I don't know if he had planned to stay here for a while or if he felt just for passing by. On the floor of the church he found this message. And the message said, "I'm sorry I was an asshole. Come to Washington. The new world gonna need Rick Grimes." Then Morgan knows, of course. Washington is the place. He knew Rick. Of course he wants to go there. Once again, more time goes by, at least a couple of months. Morgan is still on the move. He has spent the night in a crashed car. We meet up with him again when he woke up. I can still feel that he is calm and at peace with himself. He starts up the fire and make himself some breakfast. I think this is a perfect way to leave him for a while, to leave him in a good spirit and something warm in his stomach. Next on my channel, I will continue to look into Morgan Jones' life. I will also keep up with my Sansa Stark videos and do content from the book series The Legend of the Ice People. If you don't want to miss that, please subscribe to my channel and click at the notification bell. I wish you a wonderful day and thank you so much for stopping by. Welcome back.